the things about these handheld phones is you can take them in all kinds of contexts, all kinds of places, and often string together a sense of narrative and a sense of purpose, which is handy. So someone can think about some of their reading and in the context of an image or of a place where they're reading it, in a library or a quiet space where they study, they can share a reflection. Active engagement around all this is actually a function of determining whether someone's got the message, whether they receive what you are asking them to do, whether they've interacted with it, perhaps by clicking on things that are inside of that message, and then whether they've done something simple like respond to what you've asked them. It might be a response that's a simple tweet. We use hashtags on our tweets to allow them to be easily searchable. And then whether they connect in a conversation from that simple tweet across to maybe another network or to a friend, where a body of work comes together, a meme starts to coalesce. If they go beyond the social media, that means they've actually gone deep into a reading. And if you've got your analytics set up correctly, you can see whether someone's actually searched for a term or whether they've actually landed on a place you've recommended they read. And your analytics package will show how long they were there on that page, how deep they might have read that material. If the page you've asked them to click and link and visit actually has a PDF, you can see whether the PDF's been downloaded. If you've got high-end software, you might be able to tell Acrobat, Adobe Acrobat, to provide a tracking mechanism which shows you whether someone's actually read two-thirds of the way through or all the way through a document. And if you've provided some audio content, you can see whether someone's clicked on and read or listened to, read the metadata, the description of the audio file they're going to listen to, and then whether they've actually listened. So we track stats on audioboo.fm, and it shows the number of listens. Also track stats using statcounter.com on my main website. I can see where the MP3s have been listened to. Whether folks listen and then contribute by curating bits of information back into some Wikimedia, in our case we use Google Documents, that's perhaps one of the ultimate tests of engagement, and I reward those kinds of engaging mechanisms or those engaging actions some higher level of academic credits. And if they've remembered all this, they remember what they've read, remember what they viewed, they remembered what they've interacted with, well then they can answer an essay question on an exam better, or some Socrative questions I ask in Socrative.com, m.socrative.com. So this is a string of consciousness, a stream of consciousness about active engagement for learning that I'm covering in the e-learning summer school. Hopefully it'll open a concept of peer review where friends, colleagues, interested bystanders might actually say, I'm not sure I'd give that credit for academic learning or active learning, or I'd see that mechanism as a means of engagement. But in my common practice, the evidence says if you can give something, some bit of information, a bite-sized segment, in a format that they can snap and snip and share and tweet and click on, you're good to go. It's a good way of measuring active engagement. And that's hopefully the message I'll be able to share through a series of practical experiments that I'll do throughout the 2014-2015 academic year, and the process that I'll hopefully have in place during the 2014 DIT e-learning summer school this year in Dublin.